Assalamu alaikum. This is Sumbul Daniel, your lead trainer, and today we are going to study a very important and interesting topic of maths. It is average. Now, first of all, I will tell you the SLOs about this topic, solving real life problems using average and bar graphs. So, the students will be able to remember the definition and formula of average or bar graph. They will be able to apply the concept of average and bar graph in real life. Now, what is the average? The definition of it is a calculated central value of a set of numbers. It is also known as a mean value. And the formula for average is sum of data over number of data. Now, you must have heard this word average into your real lives. Can you give me some of the examples from your real life when you have heard this word average? Yes, average speed. Then, can anybody else tell me about this? Yes, average weight. Anybody else? Out of the participants? Yes, average height. So, what is the meaning of average height? Average height means that if there are 30 students in the class and some of them are 5 feet tall, some of them are 4 feet tall, so we will say that on average it is neither 4 nor 5, but we will look for a central value which will be 4.5. Now, students, I have to show you something very interesting. Look at this. Do you recognize what are these? Yes, these are some coins. Can you tell me what are the denominations of these coins? Yes, 2 rupees coins, 2 rupee coins, and 5 rupee coin. Now, students, do you know that what my problem is? My problem is that I have 3 kids at my home, but no one of them wants to take less money. They want me to distribute this money equally among them. Can you solve this problem for me? Okay. Yes, it is very interesting solution to this problem. We will go to a shop and find some change from that shop. We will get coins of smaller denominations. And then we will divide the coins equally among 3 of the kids. So, why don't we use the formula for average, which is sum of data over number of data? For this, we will sum up all of the money value, which is 2 plus 2 plus 5 over 3. And we get rupees 3. So, each of the child is going to get 3 rupees, 3 rupees and 3 rupees each. So, this is the practical use of average, that you can divide a sum of money equally among the children. Now, there is an interesting participation for you. Look what I've got for you. There is a red box. Do you think that it is empty? No, it is not empty. It is full of candies. Now, I want 3 students from the class. You will come and you can take as many candies as you want. But no peeping. So, let's have a look. What is going around? Yes, participant 1 got 4 candies, participant 2 got 6 candies, and participant 3 got 8 candies. Don't worry, children. Let me distribute these 18 candies equally among you. So, again, this formula is going to help us a lot. I will sum up all of these candies. 4 plus 6 plus 8, and I will equally divide it among 3 of you. So, in total, I got 18 candies. So, when I will distribute it among 3 of you, each boy is going to get 6 candies. So, next, I can tell you that what is the use of average in your daily life? Oh, yes, you know that it is an era of pandemic, which is COVID. So, you must have seen on television that what is the average number of new COVID cases in the last 7 days? Yes, you can find the average temperature in the last 7 days. Now, for example, if you want to go to Murray, so you have and you want to enjoy snowfall over there. So first you have to keep the record of 7 days temperature over there. Otherwise, it might happen that you go there and there is no snow, so you will be disappointed. So students, I hope that you have learned what is the average and what is its use in daily life. Now I'm going to give you a home activity. So your home activity is that you will search in your home some problem in which you want to distribute something equally, or you want to find the central value of something. And when you come up in the class the next day, you have to give me the solution to that problem. Allah Hafiz.